Yo, this is the current gas riot. This is this. Peasantry has reached new fucking levels, man. So now, me and Tommy B, that's a guy. We're in a studio, right, for a couple of days. Oh, I need to do my hair, man. We're in a studio for a couple of days with two birds and one bed. Four lads, one motherfucking bed. Vibes. Anyway, the important thing is, it doesn't fucking matter because today we're going with Nina Kravitz. Yeah, a little garden, man. Going Nina Kravitz, which if you know, you know, and if you don't, the fuck away from the channel. Just kidding. We'll get onto it. And it's our first taste of techno in a long fucking time, man. Since like fucking Ibiza, pretty much. No. Well, he went to Barcelona and got a fix, like, but I haven't really got involved since Ibiza, so stand by for footage of me getting heavily fucking involved in a bit, lads.
Today, Nina Kravitz.
Yeah, that's just getting taken to the techno scene. Yeah,
first techno.
We taught me techno for a reason, man.
This is gonna get fucking naughty, man. Absolutely rude, man. Check this shit, man. Check this shit. Yeah.
Alright, so me and Tom are fucking wavy as fuck, man, bro.
We started drinking vodka.
We went in there, went in there, let it get busy and shit.
Tommy B's fringe though was so like high thrashing.
And we came out to get more mentors because we don't have enough mentors because we only had 8 for the next like about 6 hours or something.
That's not enough, man. 30 each.
That's not enough, man. My girls are wispy as fuck, like a sheepy little cunt.
We won't feel like a
anyway,
new hair.
What we did, we went to the bottle shop and we got like a bottle of vodka.
Fucking baby motherfuckers.
Tappy Joe.
Can I put you on the YouTube channel?
Nah? I'll make you famous.
Hello, good evening.
Fucking bites.
And then we like necked it straight.
Me, grab this shit, grab it.
It's like putting hairspray in your mouth, man.
Like between three of us, me, Sam and Janos. And now Janos has gone into the shop to get us some like monster or some kind of pick-me-up, like. And we need to get back in before this vodka hits us, because otherwise we'll be wavy as fuck. And they'll be like, hey, you're not coming in, man. You're fucked, you're not coming in, so. That's the story. I'll show you fucking more techie little scenes in a bit, guys.
What's that thing? Fringes and minges, man.
Yeah. No quiff. The death of the quiff. Long live the
fringe and minges, man.
What we can do is live like we've made it before we made it. That is the fucking key to life. What's happening, fellas? How's it going? Joey D just sitting on a naughty little balcony. Last vlog entry was, well, don't drop the camera, Joe. Last vlog entry was Nina Kravitz, wasn't it? And since then we moved out of those girls' studio into a hostel for a couple of days, which was honestly, it was like banged up abroad, man. It was grim shit. And then now we're staying with a girl who has generously said that we can stay with her until we find a place. You know what? She's fucking sound, man. This is a girl who I know because she's friends with one of my ex-girlfriends. So obviously that's why it's good to like keep good fucking relationships with people in it, because you might be homeless one day and need sorting out. This is the balcony, man. Little barbecue. I'm going to be doing a lot of fucking barbecuing. Just me and Tom looking for a place now because Maddie has got off, basically. So I'll show you the little gaff, man. It's fucking nice. It's fucking beautiful. Spacious shit, man. Nice little kitchen over here. Nice mirror there, actually, isn't there? Let's do some mirror action. Dan, 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 dan. Yeah. Yeah. Still fucking shredded. Well, not really, but, you know, whatever. Right, am I zoomed out? Yeah, okay. So, no, the little kitchen, yeah. Generally, it's just fucking nice, though. It's a fucking sweet gaff, so we're going to stay here till we find a place. Just been up the road to Woolworths and a bit of a shop. I'll show you. It's all lean, quite filling shit, and clean as a motherfucker too, because I just want to get to 100% now, like, in terms of effort. So I bought some decent shit, I think. I'm tracking macros again today, as of today. So some kangaroo burgers, lean as fuck. Egg whites, gonna fucking throw some omelets together. Obviously, I'll put some normal eggs in to dilute the grimness that are egg whites. Fuckload of yogurt, because I eat a lot of fucking yogurt, man. I eat, like, too much fucking yogurt, but is there such a thing as too much? Oh, I'm growing my hair, by the way, like, literally ridiculously long. It's gonna be fucking, like, long as fuck. I'm gonna look like Thor. Ryvita, fruit, you know, cottage cheese. Now, cottage cheese is the one. I'm literally addicted to cottage cheese as well. So, that's it, yeah. What else? Macros currently are 80 protein. Not 80 protein, what the fuck are you on about, Joe? Have a coffee, man, and start this video again. Nah, one take, motherfucker. 180 protein, which is just more than a gram per pound of body weight, which is completely adequate because I'm not on particularly low calories right now. About 2,500 to 2,600 calories, which is still like maybe a 400 or 500 deficit for me, which will be fucking plenty for now. Protein will go up a little bit as I lower my calories. Fat's on really high, well, quite high fat. I'm about 80 grams of fat, which is just gives me a lot of room to play with, and I'll bring those right down as well. Let me shut the door. I'll bring fats right down as well to about maybe 60, which still isn't that low. Maybe 55 in the depths of this cut, see how it goes. Carbs are 280, I think, off the top of my head. So it's nothing extreme, but if I stick to that, I will cut at a decent rate. So I'm just gonna be fucking doing that, basically, tracking macros from now on, being back on fucking 100%, because I wanna get back to fucking, I wanna just get back to where I was and then beyond, you know. I wanna fucking really get my physique to the next fucking level and achieve the fucking pinnacle of natty greatness. Well, within reason anyway, because obviously I don't want to live like a monk and fucking train for 20 years just to get closer and closer to the natty genetic potential, because it's obviously diminished returns. 1 second. Bought some creatine as well. Brand fucking irrelevant. Creatine monohydrate, 3 to 5 grams a day. Don't bother fucking loading it. Get the cheapest one you can. When you're cutting, when you're bulking, whatever, just fucking do it, because you might as well, because it's cheap and because it fucking works. So I'm doing that too. On top of that, I will show you some fucking naughty little gear, man. My bro fucking Lipsetti over from Dublin sent me some naughty little gear. So I'm doing that shit where, you know, you get gear off like your mate who's also in fitness, and then you show everyone, and then you're like, hey guys, if you want this shit, go over to him and get some. And you know what? Like, not just saying this. Anyway, you know that Joe Delaney would not just say things for the fucking sake of it, because I have absolutely no personal interest in how much shit Rob sells. But it's fucking like some, he's got some weird stretchy shit in this. I'm gonna like message him and say, what's that fucking blend you're rolling with? Because it's not 100% cotton, and I fucking wanna know, man, because it fucking feels nice, man. So, got a little fucking shirt off him. All the way from Ireland as well, just as a gift. I think he knows how homeless I am. He's just trying to clothe me. So this is like the Joe Delaney Foundation, the Joey D Trust. Got a white one as well, which is fucking sweet. So yeah, if you want to get some fitness stuff, then yeah, got a stringer there as well. Can't be asked putting that on, because it's not a fucking fashion show. That's it. I'm gonna fucking write a program on the balcony for myself, like I keep saying I fucking will do. It's gonna be basic as fuck program, and I'll probably do a separate video explain that and upload that before this is uploaded. So look to one of my recent videos if you want to have a look at that. I'll pick up the vlog with whatever I fucking do next, basically. Obviously everyone now expects me to be on yachts with fucking honeys every week, but you know, it's just not realistic yet. But don't you fucking worry, because Joe Delaney sees opportunities in social circles, and dives the fuck in there, because that is what opens the path to yacht scenes and other similar made it scenes. So that's it. I'm gonna fucking pick up with the next fucking interesting shit I do. Over and out for now, bros. What's happening, guys? So this is a story, right? We're at Manly, came to the beach with Gados and some bird that he knows. So we're sat around on these concrete steps over here, just scouting the area for talent and stuff. And you see these two girls lying over on the beach. Tom's like, let's go speak to them. I say, they look a bit young, man, but whatever. You don't know until you try. So we walk over, we're just being like funny cunts as usual. Say, girls, hey.
Oh no.
And I, like, a few questions in, I drop the, so how old are you? Question. And they both say, what did you say, 18, yeah? 18, that's believable, right? Believable, so we continue to, like, obviously impress them and shit for a bit longer. And then, about 10 minutes in, we actually discover that they're fucking 15. And what is it? Your parents are both in the police, and your dad is. So now we're about to get up and run away dead fast before, like, we're on some paedophile documentary again. I mean, for the first time. Heavy scenes, man. So we need to rectify it by going and speaking to some, like, girls who are of legal age, but yeah. Say hi again and bye. Ciao. Yeah, that's it, man. Heavy scenes. Now we're doing that Sunday session thing at Snap Fitness. So Jados is going to smuggle us in because he loves smuggling stuff in. This lad's going stereo on the weekend. But we're gonna fucking do it. It's push day for me, so let's roll, man. Right, fellas, so this is my day one of program, and it's push strength. I say strength, but really it's just emphasis on strength as opposed to more of an actual powerlifting like program or workout. So it's just fairly low reps, like set to 5 mostly, OHPs and flat bench. I want to really like get my strength up on OHP and flat bench, so guess what I'm doing? Loads of OHP and flat bench, because that's what you do. And then I've got like just one delt accessory, just like lateral raises towards the end. So literally on 3 exercises today. I'm going to try and get some decent weights out, but I'm really going to be testing the water because I haven't been down to like 5 reps for a while. So I'm just going to see what I can do. Yados is on OHPs. See, there's 3 of us training, so it kind of suits the fact that I'm doing a more strength-based workout because I have like inevitably longer rest periods. So anyway, I'm going to try and push some decent weights and some bits. Yeah, not too bad, so we go up like 2.5k at a time. Keep testing the water, man. This is like the first time I've done this workout of the program. It's really just a case of like testing the water and finding what weights I'm gonna start off on. And then hopefully, even though I'm cutting, hopefully I can keep my calories not too far below maintenance, then being on a program will allow me to at least make some kind of strength gains, or at the very least maintain them. So first few sets, I'm not going to get anywhere near failure really. I want to be stopping like a couple of reps off failure ideally, because otherwise I'm just going to fucking burn out, and then my latter sets will be too light and it'll be ridiculous. So yeah, don't need some traps.
Come on. Come on, Tommy.
You got it, man. You got it, man. Let's go. Let's get one more. Get it. Let's go. There you go, man. It's up. Nice. Okay.
Fuck yeah. This fucking heavy, man. I know you used to do fucking.
Yeah.
He's an
OHP virgin, man.
I just fucking YOLO my training, man.
Just YOLO is it. He needs to get on that fucking program height, doesn't he? Gonna get Jadass on a fucking program, yeah, man.
I gotta step on the program.
What's the game this lad makes when I take over his fucking training? Okay, just put 2.5 plates on. Don't want to jump up too quickly, really, because you don't want to be fucking yourself over, man, getting too ambitious. It's easy to do, so I'm going to see how this set goes. Hopefully, I'll get 5 out. I should get 5 out.
What? It's about you.
Still thinking about that, mate. That'll be just hard enough, man. I'm gonna stick with that weight for now.
You recording that shit?
Yeah? Yeah, man.
Fucking tell me if he's a pedophile, bruh. So, I was going to the beach today, okay? So I got this bird the other day that I smashed. And she's fucking tidy, bruh.
Fuck yeah, fucking tidy.
So we went to the Manly to a beach that she lives beside, so I told her to come over with a few friends, but she came along, so you know, like, there was 3 guys, 1 girl, so we just, like, we're speaking a little bit to one side, so this motherfucker's going to catch some birds. Suddenly, I see him speaking with two pretty fucking tidy.
Fucking tidy.
Girls, man. And I tell my girl, like, let's go there, you know, like, to join this shit. So I go there, man, fuck. Each time I was closer, they were fucking good. And suddenly they asked me, like, how old do you reckon they are? Man, I don't know, they were fucking wearing like this surfer bikinis. I could not stop it staring at their butt,
take
you know, like.
Off that one, you
are. So I said they were 19, and it turned out they were fucking 15 years old, bruh.
That's
fucking illegal shit, bruh. You know what's the best? The best is that the fucking fathers were police officers. We fucking ran out of there.
Gym absolutely making fucking menaces of themselves, just taking the tops off and standing there like it's a fucking Chippendale show, man. Him before hate for taking your gym off, your t-shirt off in the gym, man. So fucking what? So fellas, update on living situation, man. This shit's heavy, man. Being homeless is hitting us hard. Morale's low at fucking camp. The team do stuff, man. So what happened? We had a fucking nightmare, basically. We're still staying with this girls, but we've got to be out by Thursday, right? Because we found this place. It was like a twin studio. It was decent. Like, I mean, it's fucking expensive for what it is compared to what we were living in Liverpool. But you know, it's just how it goes, isn't it? Found this twin studio. It was decent. Put some money down for it. I'm supposed to move in today, and then the woman emailed me saying, oh, there's a problem with the plumbing and I can't legally rent it to you until that's sorted out, so I'm gonna have to give you a deposit back and shit and just let you know when it's done. So she gave us that back. Had a viewing for a place today and it was fucking hideous, man. It actually said on Gumtree like immaculate or something, and I got there and it was just like fucking, it was like third world shit, man. The carpet looked like a fucking rhino just dragged its ass across it. It was fucking nasty shit. I had a viewing for a place tomorrow in Bondi, and that's got pushed back to Saturday. So basically, we just got to find a fucking gaff. Fucking difficult, man. But homelessness, man. You find me doing shifts around the doorways of Sydney's 7-Elevens with a torn-off coffee cup soon. And I'm gonna eat some fucking cottage cheese because I'm dead adventurous. I love beige food.
Jordi Lenny is my hero!